Allison.
I'm Grant.
And we're with the Winkle. And today we are making a
gearbox.
We are going to learn how to build gears inside a box. Shall we see what's in our kit today?
Yeah.
Okay.
Pieces of a pool noodle, bendy, some glue, 3 clothespins, some adhesives, and some popsicle sticks.
Great. On top of everything you have in your kit today, you will need scissors, a marker or a pencil or a pen, and you will need your box.
So don't throw it out.
Hopefully you didn't throw your box out. If you did, you can use any box that you have at home as long as it's the right size that'll fit our gears today. Are you ready to get started?
Let's do it.
Grant, gears, sometimes called cogs, are wheels with teeth that slot together. When one turns, the other one turns as well. If the gears are different size, they can be used to increase the power of turning force. The smaller one turns more quickly, but with less force, while the bigger one turns more slowly with more force. Grant, what kind of things have gears?
Cars, bicycles, and all sorts of stuff.
Have you ever seen the inside of a watch?
Yes, watches have gears too.
Yes, that's right. And a bicycle with the gears, it has that chain that's connecting it to help it go, right?
Uh-huh.
Other things that use gears, have you ever seen our can opener?
No. Wait, yes, I have. I don't see the gears though.
Yeah, it has gears on it. So when you twist the handle of the can opener, the gears are spinning, and then one of the gears is cutting open the can as you're rotating that handle. So we're gonna learn today how to make our own set of gears. Are you ready to get started?
Yeah.
Cool. As with any Winkle video, you can always pause and catch up to us if we get ahead of you. And then you can press play, okay? So don't get frustrated if you need to rewind to get the directions again and press play again. That's totally fine. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is carefully cut your pieces of pool noodle apart with your scissors. You wanna make sure these pieces of pool noodle are nice and flat because they're going to be flat inside your box. Now we only need 3 of these, but I gave you 4 just in case one tears. Okay, so for each gear, this is going to be the center of our gear, and the popsicle sticks are going to be the cogs that are around it. So for each one, we're going to be going on the opposite. So with your marker, and you can use a straight line of some sort if you need to, but make sure it goes through the middle. You're going to go on opposite sides, and then again go on opposite sides. So you have 4 equally spaced apart. Do you see that? Yeah, good idea using your clothespin. Okay, then we're going to go in the middle of each of those dots. So we have 8 dots all together.
Mine aren't dots, they're lines so I can see better.
That's fine. Great, now we have our measurements and now we're going to put in our cogs. So this popsicle stick has a very sharp edge right there. You're going to use it like this. You're going to break open that pool noodle like this, and then you can stick the popsicle stick straight in. It takes some force. Don't give up, be patient with it. Jiggle it in and you'll get used to it. So we have our line right there. I'm gonna follow that line, dig my corner of my popsicle stick into there, and then push my popsicle stick through. Just going on opposite sides first. I just find that that's easier. My brain works better that way. And I'm putting my finger in the middle, my thumb on the other side to hold it. I'm pushing those popsicle sticks in. Push it all the way through. If it pokes through the middle, that's okay. No problem at all. Hey, great job. We have all our gears built with our popsicle sticks in there. Now, so I noticed that the popsicle sticks kind of get a little jiggly, and that's not gonna work too well for our gearbox. So all you need to do is take all your sticks out, and I know you just made all that effort in getting those sticks in, I promise they'll go in a lot easier next time. Take your sticks out and get your glue and just put a little line of glue in there. If your glue's not working like mine, I just trimmed off the top of my glue bottle with my scissors and that got it working
because it's frustrating.
It can be very frustrating. So a little squeeze of glue in each of those lines and then just put your popsicle sticks back in. And then after your glue dries, they will be nice and secure inside your gear. Well, our gears are all ready, and now we're ready to put them in the box. I gave you two kinds of adhesives today, glue dots and mounting squares. Some people are more comfortable with glue dots and some people are more comfortable with mounting squares. It's just up to you. If you use the mounting squares, you need to cut them into separate pieces and cut the glue dots into separate pieces as well. We're going to be putting our first gear on the vertical part of our box, the lid that stands straight up and down. And the other gear is going to be going on the bottom of our box. So this gear that spins like this is actually going to make this gear on the ground spin.
And the center of our gear is going to have a clothespin, and that's what is going to provide a way for our gears to spin. Okay, so we are going to be putting a gear on the vertical side of our box. That's the side of the box that goes up and down. And so we want to look at that and where we should put our clothespin. We need to put it as high up as possible. So mark that spot right there. Mark that spot with your pen if you need to. And then we're going to put a glue dot or a mounting square and stick your clothespin on it. Press it in really hard. Then you can insert your gear. Now our other two gears are going to be on the flat part of the box. And we want to make sure that they're in a spot where they can cause each other to rotate, okay? So we have our vertical gear here. And we want to make sure this horizontal gear here is close enough that it'll help these popsicle sticks, or what would be normally considered the teeth of the gear, to help those turn. Okay, so right there looks like a good spot. I'm gonna take this off for right now so it's not in the way. I'm gonna mark it in the middle of the pool noodle right there, and that's where my other clothespin is going to go. I'll use a mounting square for this one. For the mounting squares, you peel off that piece of paper, press it on, and then peel off the other piece of paper. Some kids have a hard time with it, so it just takes a little bit of figuring out. Push your clothespin really tight onto there. Now let's check it, make sure it works. Mine didn't work that great, so I am going to move my mounting square a little bit closer. I think that's better because I am going to put this gear on and support those two clothespins on top of each other. I think that'll give a better stability to that vertical gear right there. Oh yeah, that is a lot more stable. Anything you can do to figure this out at home, I'm giving you the resources, I'm giving you the supplies, I'm giving you the knowledge, but if you guys feel like you want to grab something from your house that will make it work better and make it more secure or more stable or more fun, you are always welcome to do that. This gear is rotating counterclockwise, causing this gear to rotate clockwise. So which way do you think this other gear is going to go? If you said counterclockwise, you're right. Because that's what gears do. They cause the next gear to go in the opposite direction. So we have counterclockwise, clockwise, counterclockwise. So that looks like it will be a good spot for this next gear. I'm going to mark it with my pen, smash that glue dot on, and then very slowly peel off the paper. Put my clothespin on it, put my gear on it, and let's see if this works. Okay, look, that looks amazing. Just like the gears of a clock or a machine of some sort. If you want to add a handle to your gear, you could. You could add like a piece of wire, paper clip, or you could put a glue dot here and glue something to the top of that to crank it around if you want, or you can just use your fingers, that's fine too. And you know, make this your own. Troubleshoot and see how you can improve it, how you can make it special, how you can decorate it maybe. This can be your own special machine that has your own little flair to it. What do you think of your gearbox, Grant?
I like it.
Yeah, it's awesome. Grant, I had so much fun making this gearbox with you today. Did you have fun?
Yeah.
This was so cool learning about gears and how they work and function. It's something that I kind of take for granted that gears are making things go all the time. You just kind of expect it to work, right? Hey everybody, we want to see how your gearbox turned out. So if you have a grown-up, take a picture or video and post it to social media, tag us at the Winkle Crate so that we can see how your gearbox turned out. Thanks everybody, bye.
Bye.
Have fun.
Have fun.